Hello friends, while developing e-learning courses, SCORM compliance is a common term which instructional designers come across. In this video, I will cover the basic things which you as instructional designer should know about SCORM. This video will cover the following: what is SCORM, why is SCORM required, how can you make your e-learning product SCORM compliant, what are the common versions of SCORM, what is a SCO, what parts of a SCORM compliant training can you reuse, and what is the role of an instructional designer in creating SCORM compliant courses? So, what is SCORM? SCORM is an abbreviation and stands for Shareable Content Object Reference Model. It is a standard for developing e-learning products. Why is SCORM required? Let me explain this with an example. If you want to buy a memory card for your phone, you are mainly concerned about its brand, capacity and price. If your phone has the required slot, you are not concerned if the device you buy will fit into the slot or not, or whether it would be compatible with your system. Why is it so? It is so, as all these devices follow specific standards while manufacturing. This ensures that their dimensions, power requirements, and the way they communicate, etc. is similar. Similarly, SCORM provides technical specifications for how the e-learning products and the learning management system, or LMS, should interact with each other. The e-learning products which follow SCORM are said to be SCORM compliant. Such SCORM compliant products can run on any SCORM compliant LMSs. So, how can you make your e-learning products SCORM compliant? For developing e-learning products, you use authoring tools, such as Captivate, Storyline, Lectora, etc. While publishing the e-learning deliverable using these tools, you can choose SCORM as the desired compliance. The published files are in the form of a zip file. This zip file is uploaded on the SCORM compliant LMS. Please note that if the client asks you for SCORM compliant courses, you should also ask for the SCORM version that they want. Some of the common versions of SCORM are SCORM 1.1, SCORM 1.2, and SCORM 2004. SCORM compliant courses allow you to reuse some parts of the training. The smallest unit of the training that you can reuse is called a shareable content object, or SCO in short. For an e-learning course, this can be a course, lesson, topic, page, video, or animation, etc. You can compare a SCO to a single Lego block. Using the same Lego blocks, you can create different outputs like a building, house, vehicle, etc. Similarly, you can combine a SCO from a training in different ways to create new or different trainings. For example, if you have a training curriculum with 10 courses and each course should have the same leadership video at the beginning, you don't need to separately add this video in each course. Just add this video as a SCO in the first course and reuse it in all the other 9 courses. Now let's move to a very important topic. What is the role of instructional designers in creating SCORM compliant courses? Instructional designers decide which SCOs can be reused for a specific learning. They figure out the order in which the SCOs should be arranged. They decide if a specific SCO can be taken only after completing a prerequisite. They finalize if the SCOs can be taken any number of times. They keep in mind the learning objectives while arranging the SCOs. They ensure that the overall learning experience of the learners is not affected by rearranging of the SCOs. The final learning is not jerky and flow smoothly. They keep the writing style and language of the collated SCOs similar. For example, they don't collate a SCO with professional writing style and US English with another SCO that has an informal writing style and UK English. You can subscribe to this channel if you want to continue viewing interesting and informational videos on instructional design and e-learning. This brings us to the end of the video. Hope you liked it. We would be coming up with more interesting videos soon. Till then, keep learning and growing.